It's been a long time dream to get an artificial intelligence writing the code that's on your mind. If you haven't heard about GitHub Copilot, it's an app powered by OpenAI's Codex, which gives you code suggestions based on what you've typed. Now, let's take it for a spin on the React ecosystem and see how it does. Because Copilot doesn't support multiple files at the moment, and we'll see why later, let's keep everything all in one file. We'll try making a simple to-do list that is composed of two components: to-do, which will represent a single task, and to-do list that shows a list of tasks from its state. For a to-do, it's pretty straightforward and Copilot generates the right code for it. It added an onclick property as well, but turns out we'll need this later on. Moving on to the to-do list, when trying to add state to the story, it doesn't quite catch it and suggests regular props. If we just dismiss the suggestions and add more context, it understands what I'm trying to do. The same thing goes for the render section, which automatically adds code to render all the to-dos. I can also decide to remove the inline onclick handler and move it to its function, which works fine. It then manages to make the connection between toggle to-do and onclick, which is great. All right, this was working fine for React in the browser, but what if we were doing the same thing with React Native? Would it handle the differences? It turns out that by adding the right imports, Copilot understands we're dealing with React Native this time and automatically adds the right elements. We'll talk about the quality of the suggestions later. As you can see, they're more of a draft at this point than your final code. If we try the to-do list now, the result is pretty convincing and Copilot creates all the code we need. If you're unfamiliar with React Native, flat list is a virtual list of elements that optimizes any type of long list, which could happen here with our tasks. Good. After trying two different libraries, you might wonder if Copilot also works with TypeScript, and yes, it does. As you can see, it struggled a little bit more with the suggestions this time, but it quickly understood what we were trying to do. Again, this looks very similar to what we had using React. The last one we'll check is Redux. This one is interesting because it often requires a lot of boilerplate, as you know. If we add comments and describe what we need step by step, Copilot does a good job at creating a reducer for our to-do list. It's simple, but that's also because I didn't specify anything special, so it probably goes with the common use case. The provider also works fine, which is good to have. Okay, now that we've seen a few examples, it's obvious how much it can help you at times. It understands what we're doing, and even if it might not be what we would end up writing, Copilot provides a good starting point given the context we're in. This context, which is what makes it much better than any other suggestion system, is also its biggest limitation at the moment. It's sometimes difficult for AI to know what's relevant and what isn't, especially if your input is too big. In projects, you have sometimes hundreds of files, thousands of lines, and it'll be difficult for OpenAI Codex to know which parts are relevant to what you're writing now. Especially as your code base becomes large, it's hard to see the big picture and keep everything consistent. If Copilot can understand at large what your coding style is, how you usually code within your project, and not only comparing a part of your file to how people usually code, this will bring better results that fit your code base. That being said, I'm sure it's doable and it'll come in due time. Another important thing to look at is code quality, and while Copilot worked well with our examples, it wasn't perfect. At least for now, your knowledge is crucial to know if what it suggests is optimized and fits well in your project. In its state, Copilot is great as a code shortcut, good suggestions without leaving your editor. See it as a way for you to be more productive and let AI handle the boring parts of your job. It might not replace Stack Overflow, but that's a step forward. Anyhow, thanks for watching and see you next time.